Just a couple of housekeeping things to just to begin with. Well, welcome, everybody welcome. Thank you for coming today to help us celebrate the official opening of the new Augusta Fire Rescue Station 1. As always, I'm going to try to keep things light and rolling right along as we get through speeches. And what's likely going to be the coolest ribbon cutting that you've ever seen. There's also a set of unwritten rules to respect each member of the fire department, respect each other, be there for each other in the community in its time of need, to attend parades, to attend the funerals, backyard barbecues. Lastly, pride. This is a sense of pride that we have every day. The pride in our equipment, the pride in our stations, the pride that we feel when we are out in our communities doing public education, fire prevention, or helping at an active scene. The pride that we feel when we complete more training and make ourselves better, to better serve our community.
To the brave men and women who will grow here, build it and they will come, is often what people say. I would like to add, build it and they will succeed. Because what you have built is a home. A home where firefighters can develop their skills, build friendships that will strengthen this community, and stand as a beacon providing shelter to all times of emergency.
A one-bay fire hall was erected on the Webster land and officially opened January 26, 1958. The department had its baptism on January 8, 1958 when it entered its first call. Late in 1958, Augusta Fire Department joined the Leeds and Granville Mutual Aid System. Within a month, they were called to assist in a major fire at King Street in Brockville. Our two stations currently house two pumpers, two tankers, two rescue trucks, two 4x4 trucks, a UTV equipped medical responses, as well as forest firefighting equipment.
Some of you may have had the opportunity in the past to view the old station. And you will certainly remember the lack of space for the fire trucks and equipment. At most, we had 2 feet between each vehicle, not to mention the drivers had to manipulate the trucks every which way to get them in the bays.
First, we'd like to welcome everyone to our new Augusta Fire Rescue Station Number 1. This station was designed to help ensure the safety of our firefighters with features such as bunker gear, clothing, cleaning facilities, and showers for proper decontamination, location to clean our breathing apparatus, a small fitness facility, larger bay doors and vehicle floor space, storage areas and space with design in each room, appropriate bunker gear storage area, and a compressor room that deadens the sound so we don't have to wear hearing protection throughout the station. This new station replaces an old station that served our residents well for over 60 years, and we look forward to this one doing the same. We have learned that fire stations aren't just made of brick, mortar, wood and steel. They are made of the community, the blood, sweat, and the tears of firefighters past, present, and future. This station, the station in North Augusta, the vehicles and equipment are yours, the residents of Augusta. This is a new station and a fire service that you can be proud of, and make no mistake, we have one hell of a fire department. We strategically planned our open house today, the first day of Fire Prevention Week. The theme this year is Not Every Hero Wears a Cape. Plan and practice your escape. We ask everyone here today that when you go home, you be the hero. Test your smoke and carbon monoxide alarms, practice your home fire escape plans, and if you don't have one, create one and practice it. So if fire strikes, your family's safe. And in appreciation of our past, please take a moment to view the conference table in our debriefing room, our alternate emergency command center, that was designed and constructed by our firefighters, Vicki and Maynard Vanderbilt. We are blown away by the final product and grateful, so grateful for their skills.